Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I have a very special MZ Wallace bag reveal to share with you guys. But before I jump into it, I do want to let you know that some of the links in the description box below are affiliate links, which means that if you decide to click on them and make a subsequent purchase, I will earn a small commission at no extra cost to you. Without further ado, I'm just going to show you guys this very, very special MZ Wallace bag. The leather Micro Sutton. Look at that. How beautiful is it? I am so happy that MZ Wallace decided to re-release some leather bags. This was purchased during their 12 days of surprises. I think I said the promotion correctly. And if I recall, today, the day the video is gonna go live, is the last day. So hopefully we've ended with a really fantastic surprise, though I don't know how you can top leather. I had a leather bag, actually two of their leather bags in the past when they initially released a couple styles in their leather and ended up selling them just for trying to keep my handbag collection in general a small and concise collection. I've since regretted selling them at times, but figured, you know what, everything happens for a reason. And I was proven correct when this was released halfway through this promotion of theirs, because you guys, I've had my eye on the Micro Sutton for ages and just never pulled the trigger. I don't know why. I guess this must be why. This is the most perfect bag as far as size, as far as the fact that it's leather. It's just fantastic, and I can't wait to dive into this and show you guys everything about this bag, the differences that I've noticed between this release and the previous release of leather, show you mod shots, all that good stuff. So let's dive in. Let me get this on camera here for you guys so you could see it. Now, according to the MZ Wallace website, the leather Micro Sutton is 7 inches in length, 6.75 inches in height, 4.75 inches in width. This handle drop right here is 2.7 inches. The crossbody strap, let me grab it right here. The length on the crossbody strap can be anywhere from 26.4 inches all the way to 45.3 inches. The bag itself, and I assume with the crossbody, weighs 0.55 pounds and it retailed for $325. Now, unfortunately, I'm sad to say that it is sold out, and I don't know if they're gonna bring more. From what was said online, once it's gone, it's gone. So I'm really bummed to be sharing something that is at the moment inaccessible for purchase, but you never know, they could change their mind, because you know, all us MZ Wallace fans out there do really love their leather pieces when they do come out with them. So maybe they'll come out with more, re-release, maybe have a permanent collection of leather. You know, girl can dream. You might find it on the resale market. They may get some returns and it'll pop up online again. You never know. Just because of all those what ifs, I figured I would film this video and share so that if and when you may come across this bag, you will have something out there to refer to so that you can decide whether or not you would want to purchase it. Now, before I dive in, I have to tell you, I've dabbled and played around with the Micro Sutton at department stores when I've seen it and always felt like it was small. And that's what I was expecting when this came, but I don't know if it is. It feels bigger than the micros I've seen in store, and that could be because it's leather and has a little more structure to it. The Oxford material is very squishy, smushy, and so for that reason, it could just appear smaller when I've played around with it in the past at the department stores. And despite the measurements online being identical to this versus all the other Micro Suttons that are available, they are the same. For some reason, this feels bigger to me. I don't know. I think it might just be because of the fact that it's in leather and has more structure to it. I would imagine if I tried to hold the micro like this and it wasn't leather, it would just, you know, completely fall back. So that could be the culprit here. But I don't know, you guys, like, I just feel like all of a sudden the micro seems like bigger to me than it is and feels like the more appropriate size bag for me in today's world. Like, even the small sometimes feels too big. So this is really so perfect, and I am so glad I opted for this one. During the 12 days of surprises, the two leather pieces that they released were this Micro Sutton and then Pippa, which if you're not familiar with it, I believe it's still online. You can go and check it out. I will link it down below as well as this bag so that you can check it out because I don't think they are removed from their site just yet. So you can get a better look at them. I kept going back and forth between this one and Pippa and which one do I order? Do I order both and then decide when they come home? And I just opted for this because I felt like the ease of putting items in here would be much easier than the Pippa. The Pippa is a flatter bag, so I felt like it would require a little more strategy, a little more method to my madness, as I like to say, when it comes to packing the bag. With this one, I can just throw everything I need in willy-nilly. Like, I don't need to think about it. I don't need to plan where what goes. It all gets in here. It all closes, zips up, no problem. And that's that carefree feeling of packing my bag is really what I wanted with a more elevated look, and this bag accomplishes that for me. So let me show you up close. It's gorgeous, gorgeous leather. You just want to sniff it. It smells so good. And actually, speaking of the leather, when I first saw it, it totally gave me Chanel So Black, 17S So Black vibes. And I grabbed my card holder to show you. This is the Chanel 17S So Black next to the MZ Wallace, and I just feel like they are long lost relatives that have reconnected. I love it. So, you know, knowing how much I love this, if you've seen my videos, you know I'm obsessed with this particular season of leather So Black from Chanel, that when this came, I was just instantly, like, there was no issue. I said if there was any hint of doubt in my mind that this would go back because it is very expensive, but as soon as I saw it, I knew it was staying. And now we know why. They resemble each other a lot. So the leather on this is absolutely gorgeous. As you can see here, the MZ Wallace nameplate is in black, and the hardware on this bag is gunmetal. Let me get it up close so you can see. We've got the red trim that we've all come to know and love from MZ Wallace. The back is clean, no pockets or anything like that. Very typical for the Micro Sutton. The bottom has its 4 feet and the diamond logo in the center right there. You've got zipper pulls, obviously, right here, two of them with gunmetal detail. And this was something that surprised me. Oh, let me show you up here at the top, the leather handles, got the untreated leather right there. I, you know, from the pictures I saw online, I knew the lining was different, but I didn't expect it to be like this. And I hope the video is showing it to you properly. It's kind of like a sateen. It is so soft to the touch. I was expecting their traditional lining, just like all the other bags, non-leather bags, but it is different. You can see there's a little sheen to it. Yeah, there, you can see a little sheen right there. And it's just so luxurious. It feels amazing. So it is just, I can't say enough good things about this bag, you guys. Let me unhook these sides here because I do want to be able to show you the interior a little better. Now, some things to note with the Micro Sutton compared to all the other sizes of the Sutton, there are some differences internally with the design of the bag. So first off, you only get one pocket here, one big pocket versus the two that you've come to know and love from the interior of MZ Wallace bags. Only one here. You do not have that card compartment right here that's typically found underneath the zipper compartment, and you do not get a little tether with a market pouch attached. That just does not come with this bag, probably because of the fact that it is so small. So those are just some details that I wanted to note to you guys so that you are aware that those are differences and not to expect them if you decided to buy a Micro Sutton. As I was contemplating which bag to order, as I was waiting for this bag to arrive, and as I started to peek around at this bag when it finally came home, I observed a number of differences between this release of leather bags from MZ Wallace and their previous one, which included the small leather Sutton and the small Metro. I jotted them all down because I do want to flag all these differences in the event that any detail from the past that you like does not exist here, so you are aware of it. So if you see me looking down, it's because I want to make sure I touch on all the differences, all the points that I did note. So first things first, hardware. In the previous release, the hardware was silver. Here, it is gunmetal. I actually really love this. It kind of gives a very monochromatic, sleek look. I prefer it like this. I feel like it makes it more versatile. I like the neutrality of gunmetal because then you can do everything else gold if you wanted and not feel like the one-off thing in your outfit are the silver hardware on your bag. So I do like the gunmetal more than the silver because of the versatility that it affords you. I think, and for a couple of these points, I'm kind of going off memory, so if I'm wrong, I apologize, but I'm pretty sure the previous release of leather did not have any red trim to it. Here we've got it, as you can see here, and on these zipper pulls, and that is another difference, the zipper pull with the previous release, and mostly I should say that I am thinking and referring to the small Sutton, not so much the Metro. The previous release of leather had one zipper pull. It was a metal, roughly rectangular metal zipper pull with a piece of leather, untreated leather like this, sticking out, and you had that one zipper pull. Here you've got two, and I love the fact that it's two. I actually liked the look of the one zipper pull. I prefer the zipper pull from the previous release. I felt like it looked a little more elevated, and it was a little more special than this, because you see this zipper pull on all the other Metro, Oxford, Sutton bags. So I liked the uniqueness of that, but I do prefer having two zippers because you can zip it open or closed any which way. With that one, obviously you were limited to opening it in one direction and closing it in another. The other difference here, let's see, I touched on all those. The leather quilts, in my opinion, are not as puffy on the new one. I feel like in the previous release, the leather quilting was puffy, kind of like how it is here, all throughout the bag. On this release, the leather is much flatter. Now, I am indifferent about this. I don't know if it's just for the sake of changing things up that this is a flatter leather. Perhaps they discovered that the leather flattened over time, or the puffiness, I should say, of the previous release flattened over time, and maybe it didn't look good. I don't know. It's an indifferent difference to me, to be honest, but it is something I did observe and wanted to disclose to you guys. One more thing on the exterior before I go inside, the crossbody strap. As I had this sitting across from me in my room, I started to notice that I was pretty sure the crossbody strap was different. So I pulled out the crossbody strap that came with my mini Metro tote. And in fact, I did confirm that the crossbody strap is a little different. So here is the strap that comes with this leather bag. Let me turn it this way. And as you can see, it's very shiny and more luxurious feeling. This is the strap from the Mini Metro. So there is a difference. Also in, like, I don't know what to call it, the print of the crossbody strap, the weave. I'm not entirely sure what the proper term is, but you can see that it's different here. Here you've got like some V, like almost like herringbone, but not enough to call it herringbone. But you can see that there is a difference in just the look of it, the sheen. There is a difference in the crossbody strap. I think that the width is the same. Yeah, the width is the same, but definitely a difference in the strap itself. And lastly, the interior. As I mentioned and showed you earlier, the interior in this bag is very shiny, almost like a sateen. It was not something I expected in the best way possible. Like I told you guys, I thought it was going to be the same lining as any other bag. It is not. The previous release of leather had, I think, I don't know exactly what they called it. Either it was like a microfiber, micro suede. It was almost suede-y in its look, and the color I think was a little more neutral, like a tannish color. This is more of a very light blush, pale pink and sateen. I'm loving this interior. I think I really prefer it more than the interior of the previous leather. And again, who knows why that change happened? It could be they discovered something negative as far as the wear and tear of that interior. Perhaps they just wanted to change things up. I'm not sure, but I do love this interior far more than the previous release. I think it almost feels like if something were to happen in here, it could be easily wiped off too with this interior. With the other one, I would have been really scared if something stained or spilled in there. I feel like I would have been in deep trouble, like wouldn't be able to clean it out. With this one, I feel like I have a little more confidence. Not that I carry anything that would spill. I think the worst thing I'd carry would be water. So I think this interior will be a little more durable if you're the type of person that carries things that could possibly spill and create a mess inside, or even if you don't and it just happens by accident, I feel like this interior is going to be a lot more durable in that regard as well. Now what I want to do is show you how much this bag can hold. Like I said, I feel like this bag will be very easy and carefree when it comes to packing it. I won't have to think or worry about how I put my items in here. It'll all just fit just fine, I assume, with plenty of room to spare and close without any issue. So let's start with the first thing, which is the phone. I'm filming on it. I've got my case right here. I have an iPhone 12 Pro Max, and I'll put it right in there. I've got my mini wallet, the Chanel Snap card holder. I've got my Louis Vuitton car key case. I've got a pair of sunglasses. I've got my mask because COVID. And I've also got my lip product right here. And I'll put that in here. And actually, this one interior compartment on the other side might be a really great place to put that mask. So instead of throwing it in there just with everything else, I will put it in that little compartment right there. And that is pretty much everything I carry these days when I'm going to run errands. And as you can see, I just threw them in there. I didn't have to worry about which way they went in and what order and if they were vertical or horizontal. It just all went in there. Zip it closed. Easy. Love that. I love not having to worry about how to put things in here. This is fantastic. And I've got room to spare, you guys. This size bag I felt like was not going to be for me ever. And let me tell you, I feel like I've been saying this a lot these days, but my, how times have changed. A year ago, I would have never considered it. Now I feel like everything else is too big. So this bag is great. This size is great. I love it. I can't wait to use it. If you were one of the lucky people like me to have picked up one of their leather bags, be it this one or the Pippa, let me know in the comments below which one you picked and what your thoughts are. And if you had or still own one of their previous leather bags, what do you think? Do you like the changes? Anything you prefer in one release versus the other? Let me know all that good stuff below. Let's talk about the MZ Wallace leather bags this week. With that being said, we have reached the end of this video. I do want to thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button down below, as well as ding the bell that you see right there. That way you will be alerted every time I upload a video. I will now step back and provide you with the mod shots that I promised earlier on in this video. I will show you how this bag looks on me handheld, as well as a shoulder carry and then a crossbody carry as well. And for reference, I am 5'6". Thank you again for watching, and here are the mod shots.